Hi guys, it's Michelle. So I am here today and just got a wee makeup tutorial to do and filmed it on the proper camera rather than trying to faff around with my phone and hope for a good resolution. So guys, I hope this is okay for you. The look that I have done, what's on them eyebrows at the moment, I have used the karity eyeshadows, which I just received in the post yesterday, and they are incredible. Karity shadows are immense. They are so good. So guys, yeah, I highly recommend them to you. You can buy loads of different shades. I have my Karity Travel Chamber, which I ordered as well. I ordered one of the palettes, and I ordered a few loose shades as well. And basically, depotted my palette, which was really silly, not realising that they weren't magnetic. Then had to stick them into the travel chamber. Doesn't matter though, I wanted them all together. So yeah, there are a whole host of shades. Got loads of nice kind of brown. These are all Karity Beauty, all of these gorgeous shades. These are incredible. They are very reasonable priced, and the pigment on them is amazing. The pigment is incredible. If you want to see how I got that look, you're in the right place, and just stay tuned to see me in some of my crazy. I don't know how long this video has lasted, so I might have to kind of skip through a load of it or voice over some of it if I'm talking too much of it. I have my MAC Pro Longwear paint pot, and I have it in painterly just now. When this is done, I'm going to be going to probably, I'm going to buy something else. I decided ages ago I wanted to start using kind of like cruelty free brands, and it's been a bit of a thing for me. However, I'm not going to throw out the products that I already have. I still have this stuff last an age. I've had this for a long time, and just the fact to only use it. But anyway, dabbing this powder all over. This is just to kind of set the MAC, you know, so that I can then get a base for blending my shadows. Don't really know what I'm going to do. I don't think I'm going to do anything too wacky and wild and mental. May add a pop of colour. May not. We shall see. I kind of feel like I should, just because we have some colour there. I have these kind of blues and purpley shades and stuff, and that wee blue there, that navy. It's just gorgeous. Okay, so I have my Makeup Geek Morocco. I've just realised I'm not actually using a mirror at this point in time. That's a bit silly, I should really be getting a mirror. So I know what I'm doing. Instead of feeling my way around, I'm going with the teeny toty viewfinder of my wee Canon. Because then I'll be like, whoa, that's not worked, what's going on? That's actually not too bad. So I'm wanting to bring that right to the inside here. I'm on steroids at the moment, and one thing steroids always do to me, the oral steroids for my asthma, anytime I'm ever on oral steroid tablets, they can cause kind of fatty deposits to gather within your face. They always do with me. Once I come off them, they tend to dissipate and disappear fairly quickly. One place I always get fatty deposits when I'm on corticosteroids orally is right in here. I get these big kind of lumpy fatty chunks. So I am not wanting anything shimmery on this part here, and I do want to carry this shadow right over anyway. Right here, this one here. I should have really kept this in the palette. My daughter actually said to me, Mum, you should keep that in the palette and know the names of them. And plus the palette is like super pretty. It comes in the kind of hard cardboard palette, which it really is pretty. I'm gonna go for this wee light shade here now. It's a Karity as well. She's like, then you know the names, blah, blah, blah. I was like, ah, no, it's fine. So I'm just putting that under the brow bone. I'm keeping it all matte just now because I don't really know at this stage exactly where I'm going with the rest. I will end up probably putting a wee bit of shimmer under that brow bone there. Before just now, you'll just do this. This is the Karity E25. It's quite a kind of, it's quite a flat kind of brush. My brain's a way to smoosh today. I don't know what's happened to me. My karity E31. And just give that a wee blend. Blendy blend. So we'll go with this turquoise to start, this kind of greenishy blue. Wow, that's like really opaque, really pigmented. I really like that, that's gorgeous. Whoa, obviously this is over concealer, so it is going to look really, really right, because I've put a really light shade under to kind of help give that extra pop. But yeah, that's really beautiful. It is very opaque anyway. And this is one of the karity colours. So I believe they're 1.8, 1.6-ish, 1.5 grams of colour. Just that. Now we're going to this. I'm excited. Again, this is matte, and oh my goodness, this is full on opaque coverage. Wow. On the outer side, I'm going to go with this other kind of navy blue type shade. Now I have kind of hoodied down turned eyes, so what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to bring some of that up. And I'm going to use a bit of that there. And then I'm going to use a bit of the brown after. So I'm following the shape of my crease here. Because I have the hooded, like you can see my eye. Right, so this here, this brown, it's quite a nice warm brown. You can see what I've done here. And same on this side. So we do have, I brought that turquoise up. But I'll bring that brown along. Okay, it's karity E31 brush again. Blend that brownie shade over here slightly. And actually the brown looks like it's taken over a wee bit, but that's fine because I can always go back into the navy. This is where it could all just go so wrong, so wrong, so quickly. So what I'm going to do is just between each of the shades here, this crease brush, the tiniest swirly motion. So I'm going in with a bit of the lightest, the turquoise, between these two, to blend. Any blue shade, to blend that into the turquoise. These colours actually blend so nicely together, they really are easy to work with, they're brilliant. Just dot that all over. Oh, right down face, that's why I don't do foundation first. Greeny shade, bring that over into my turquoise. Wow, these blend amazingly, guys. I really recommend these karity if you've never used them, they are so good. So incredible. So I grab a wipe and clean up all my mess that I have made. I've made a big mess. Karity! I need to do my under eye, but I'll do that after I've done all my foundation and the lights. My Maybelline Lasting Drama Gel Liner. I actually dipped my brush into that and then squished my brush right on down. This is the best ever. Ever. Yep, like it. Get me some brows on. I'm going to use my Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade and I'm going to use the shade Chocolate today to do my brows. I was semi-tempted to do blue eyebrows. I am still semi-tempted. I have no brows, no hair on my brows because I have alopecia. So the eyebrows are nothing like what I was planning on doing. However it works, I'm happy with it. I've been using Marula oil all over my face and using that and counting that as my kind of priming type thing lately. And I quite like it. I'm going to use the Milani 2-in-1. Conceal and Perfect Foundation. I have shade 00, which is light and natural. And I'm gonna use my new karity brush. So soft. I'm just pumping this straight onto my face because it's one of these days for me today. So yeah, I had the lightest, well, what I thought was the lightest, the 01 Milani Conceal and Perfect shade, which I liked, but I had to lighten up because it was still too dark for me, the creamy vanilla. I used to use shade 2. I've gotten so light though. So shade 1, shade 1, was still too dark. This is a lot better. I like that it's light, but it's still yellowy toned. So, actually this is pretty good going for me. Sorry, I'm just pumping this straight on my brush. It's pretty good shade actually for me. I don't know if it's still ever so slightly dark for me. Rest of my body. It's not bad. I am going to use my Tarte Shape Tape. Go for the whole Illuminati, the makeup Illuminati triangle. Ah. No, this is how fair I am. This is the Tarte Shape Tape in light, and it's not going to be brightening up very much on my face because it's the shade of me. I could do my whole face in Tarte Shape Tape. How cool would that be? Be like the best coverage on the planet. I am going to use my Cover FX Illuminating Setting Powder, loose powder. This stuff is incredible. If you have extremely dry or dehydrated skin, if you have fine lines and wrinkles, like me. I've got loads of lines and wrinkles under my eyes. Even the Tarte Shape Tape will start to sink into them, and everything else is like a million times worse than that on me. This stuff is just, honestly, it's just the best ever. It just seems to set, but it kind of allows the light to reflect. I don't know, my nose and stuff with it. Just set the rest of my foundation. That was just a big powder brush. This is my F21 by karity. Hello! Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. I wish you could buy this in the UK. You can't, you just need to buy it online.
like this brush.
Yep.
Karity, you're awesome. You have a new fan.
Ta-da!
So I'm gonna use, actually there, and this colour switch tool is the best invention ever. I love the fact that you just give your brush a wee whoosh, takes all the powder off it. Obviously it's not a proper kind of clean, deep clean thing, but between colours it's great. So I'm just doing the contour for my nose. I always do mine from right here and bring it down. From the eye. Even if I don't have one heavy eyeshadow, I still always do the nose contour from. Let's just do this today and see what happens, see what I think. Using my Milani Luminosa blush today because I love it. That's the reason. It's nice, it's not like pure sparkly shimmery, but it has a wee bit of a sheen to it. I love the shade, the kind of orangey peachy. The shades that I have used for my eyeballs. I'm going to go for a probably an orange lip as well. Let's just be bold with colour today. Be bold with colour. That sound that you heard is the sound of my makeup coming crashing down. I got this Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit Sun Dipped. This is my first Anastasia Glow Kit. I'm really white. Anyway, I go very dark in the summer, I do. I thought this would be far too dark for me just now. It's actually not. It's actually not. Sorry, I just have to do this. So we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4. Look, guys. I'm using my Real Techniques brush. And what I guess I love about this, I have always. Let's talk highlight. Let's be real. I do love highlight. I have generally always loved the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Pressed, and it has been my go-to and my perfect highlight. And if I'm honest, I didn't try the Anastasia Beverly Hills because I found a product I liked. No, I found a product I love and I was happy with it. So I was kind of like, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. It's crazy, it's crazy.
It's crazy.
Thinking that you should go for a kind of nude lip with all that I've got going on. I haven't even done my falsies yet. I've not done my under eye either. Let's get this under eye done. I have my Nanshi pencil brush. This was karity shade. This little karity shade. And this gorgeous blue karity shade. It's what from the Morphe Gunmetal collection, it's the G13. I really like this. By the way, L'Oreal Paris is a brand that I've never really used in the past and I've just kind of started to use some of their products. I found this Nude Gold Obsession, Nude Gold range, and this shade is Obsession. If you want to go nude, this would be so pretty. Although I kind of think I want to go full on bright. I do want to go full on bright. I don't think, I know. This is going to be brilliant or terrible and I ain't sure which. So, who's this even by? Is this Maybelline? Maybe. Maybe it's Maybelline. sorry, that was not funny. Orange Danger, Maybelline New York. Shade 83. Right, in theory, nude would be beautiful, I think, with the kind of bold eye. I do think that nude would be maybe the best bet, but I've decided that I've gone for something really bright on the eye and I want to kind of go for a contrasting complementary shade. If this is rotten, I'll take it off and put on nude. I'm not even lining my lips, what am I doing? Yeah, nah. I feel a bit like a clown. Okay, so I've just put Revlon glue along my eyeliner and I'm using the Ardell lashes number 113. Sorry, shorter down the corner, longer towards the outside. These are very long, very kind of wispy, super cute. I don't have any eyelash here anyway with my alopecia. No eyelashes, so I just stick the glue straight on to the eyelid. And it makes it easier for me because then I can't really go wrong with where I place the lash because it'll not stick anywhere else. I'm so awkward, I put that orange on and then I'll like, oh. Nude Gold, and the shade is Obsession. I think that's better. Look at my tattoo. I'm so in love with this piece of art. Okay, so guys, Karity eyeshadows, I 100% recommend. You can buy, they have some made up. They have actually some that you can buy that come in the travel chamber that have got a few colours and you get the big large magnetic travel chamber free with it, which is amazing. I like this look. I kind of like what I've achieved with the Karity shadows today. This is very different for me. It's not something I would always go out wearing. However, it is something that I like and I've not even set my face. What is that about? What is that? Okay, Milani, make it dewy. Make me dewy. If I hadn't put on eyelashes, I would be doing my usual, do you know what I usually do before I do my eyelashes? I use a hairdryer. And I dry my face with a hairdryer. I think I'll change my Apple Watch strap to my blue one today. Get myself matching. And I'm going to put on some hair. Yes! I love this hair. This is my Ellen Villa Pure Power Human Hair Luxury, Luxury Wig. Again, Ellen Villa US. I owe you so many thanks. The Karity eyeshadows, I highly recommend, guys, if you are considering buying them. Obviously, I have gone for something kind of bright and bold, and I like this kind of look. It's not a look that I ever wear or ever do. But I kind of like to do something different for a change. I am very much these days into kind of do what makes you feel happy about yourself, do what makes you feel like you. And today, this makes me feel like me. I have headwear which is going to match these eyes incredibly. And lips. The new shade is going to match that. Yeah, so this is me for today. This is my finished look. I'm just going to be sitting in my house, but I like it. So guys, thanks for watching. I hope this was okay for you. Sorry that I talk so much rubbish, but see you on the next video. Bye.